Hello everyone, welcome to Jack's Top 10. In this video we talk about 10 sacrifices you need to make if you want to be rich. So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to this channel for our future update. What's keeping you from being rich? In most cases, it's simply a lack of belief. To become rich, you must believe you can do it, and you must take the actions necessary to achieve your goal. Everyone in this world wants to be rich, but only a few can do what it takes to become rich. Dave Ramsey, a great entrepreneur, always says, "You can't work 3 hours a week and make $100,000. Get rich quick doesn't work. Crockpot mentality always defeats microwave mentality. The journey to success is not easy. For one to become rich and successful, there are many principles that you need to follow, important risks that you need to take, and also there are many sacrifices that you need to make. Here are the list of 10 sacrifices you need to make if you want to be rich. Number 10. Comfort. The luxury lifestyle, the first-class travels, the private jets, the most expensive cars. That is the end result of living way below your means for several years or decades. Unless you are born rich, you have to struggle to get there and sacrifices must be made. Sacrifice comfort for your personal development and long-term growth. You don't need to be spending your first alerts on new iPhone when you have a working phone. You don't need a bigger apartment in your 20s or 30s. Cut down on rent, use the remaining on something more productive. Poor people spend money trying to look rich, while rich people are busy getting rich and richer by acting like they are poor. There is no need for early comfort. Number 9. Entertainment and TV. There is no need for you to be watching 10 seasons of Friends or the latest season's DVDs out there. Poor people always justify wasting time in one form or the other. Especially if you are just starting out in your career. Why should you be watching all the live matches on EPL when your job is not sports commentator or TV sports analyst? There is no need to be too on social media 24/7, unless your business is prospecting clients or doing something valuable to your online business then. You need to be putting in work hours and creative powers using your time. You can be that complacent unless you want to fail. Number 8. Sacrifice the friendship with poor people. I decided long ago never to be friends with poor people, and what I mean by poor people here isn't those people who have no money. The truly poor people are those who are not ambitious. If you hang out with people who are not ambitious, you won't be ambitious. If you hang out with people who make excuses, you end up making excuses. If you hang out with people who expect the economy to be better before they'll be rich, you'll do the same. Let go of negative people. Surround yourself with positive and ambitious people, and you'll be rich because they will challenge and encourage you to dream big in your life. Number 7. Sacrifice the blame game. I grew up in a society where most people blame the government, the economy, or their parents for their poverty. However, when I was around 17, I decided to stop that nonsense. Blaming other people for your situation makes you happy because you have the feeling that after all, it's not your fault. The problem with this mindset is that since you think it's not your fault, you also think someone else should help you out, maybe the government, your parents, or the economy. I'm sorry, nobody is going to help you to become rich. If you want to be rich, you'll sacrifice the pleasure you're getting from blaming other people. You'll take 100% responsibility for your life. Get out and get your hands dirty. Number 6. Sacrifice the shining objects. For more than a decade after I had made the decision to be rich, I didn't buy any shining objects, didn't use latest phones, TV, clothes or shoes. I bought nothing except it was very important for my existence or business. My idea about money is, make it, invest most of it and manage anything that remains. I have days when I and my wife were broke, even though we were making more money than most people. We were broke because we invest almost everything we earn. I won't tell you that it's easy, but it's a sacrifice that's worth it. Would you rather be a lion one day and be respected all your life, or you'll be a sheep with no honor all the rest of your life? Would you rather sacrifice those new phones, clothes, wristwatches and TV sets now or be an average man for the rest of your life? Robert Kiyosaki said rich people buy luxury last, while poor people buy luxury first. If you want to be rich, you must be disciplined enough to sacrifice the shining objects, invest a significant percentage of your income, and manage whatever remains. Number 5. Hobbies. Hobbies, ain't nobody got time for that. Hobbies by their nature produce very little values to both yourself and your immediate environment. Not only that, to maintain a hobby it demands time, attention and most of the time financial resources as well. If you want to be rich and you're not being you want to be in life, you can't afford to have a hobby. That's the truth. You can go golfing, paint landscapes or whatever you find worthy of calling you. Hobby after you have taken care of the basis. I'm broke. Why do you have a hobby when you can't take care of yourself? A hobby should be the last thing on your mind. Number 4. Extravagant lifestyle and impulsive buying. Another habit that the poor should sacrifice to become rich is, by all means, avoid impulsive buying and living a flashy lifestyle. What usually separates the millionaires from the rest of the world is how they manage debt. They don't live an extravagant lifestyle, instead, they only buy what they need and can pay for. They do not book hotels and flights by using their credit cards to pay for them. They are conscious of the interest rates even when they use credit cards or take loans. If possible, they try to pay with cash because of its 0% interest rate. Number 3. Time. The road from zero to financial success takes an average of 7 to 10 years, depending on the industry and your emotional intelligence, your intellect, your ability to play the market, and the volume of work you are able to put out another to make it happen. Guess what? The days you spend on your computer on negotiating with clients are probably not going to be the best years of your life, but it's a sacrifice one needs to make if you're serious about getting rich, because it's a sacrifice one needs to make if you're serious about getting rich, because it's that time that yields the result you're looking for. 7 years might sound like a lot of time, and it doesn't mean that those will lack any positive memories. Time will pass another way, so make sure that you invest it wisely. Ask yourself the following question. Are you willing to eat shit for several years and other to eat caviar for the rest of your life? Number 2. Health. Health is one of the most important ingredients to a successful life, but I'm focusing on getting rich. The paradox is that most people sacrifice health and other to get money and sacrifice the money to regain their health. We all like to believe in the idea of the iconic image of the entrepreneur working 16 hours per day and going to gym for 2 more hours, eating vegetables and meditating for at least 1 hour every morning, but the truth is the road to riches will take a turn of your health. The most common feeling is that of tiredness because most individuals have difficulties falling asleep. The goal keeps you up at night. There are worries to consider, and everything depends on your abilities to manage them. Entrepreneurs live with the tremendous amounts of stress in their lives. They usually neglect their health in the pursuit of success. Number 1. Who you are. If you want to be wealthy, if you want to be successful, you need to sacrifice who you are in order to become who you want to be. It's okay to think of yourself as a work in progress, similar to a software. This is your current version, but don't be afraid to make updates, fix bugs, and reiterate what makes you, you. Your current reality didn't make you rich. The current version of yourself wasn't able to alive the puzzles needed to further your achievements from a finance standpoint, so you need to do something about it. Evaluate who you really are. What are the things that set you back? What are the things that the current version of yourself failed to do? Then seek ways to transform yourself in that department. An easy aspect to point out is discipline. If you lack discipline, you're probably never going to become successful. Poor people always lack discipline. This is because success in any form comes from repetitive actions which add up everywhere time. Unless you can discipline yourself, you won't stand a chance. Discipline is one of the traits that determines success in life. Thanks for watching video.